Angle, David here, and on this video, we're going to continue our series on what factors does Airbnb use to determine how they're going to push or list your property in a search. There's three factors, and if you want to see what those factors are, just click on the video below, which is the first video that I did in this series. It's titled Airbnb Tip Number 5, and you can see what those three factors are. But on this video, I'm going to specifically talk about factor number one. And factor number one is guest needs. Before I go into that, I want to explain why I'm doing this series. This series is geared towards the host, and more importantly, it's geared towards that host that's an investor. Or if you are an investor or want to be an investor on short-term rentals, these are the criteria that you should be using when buying your property. So let's begin. Guest needs, some of the stuff that Airbnb uses to determine what the needs are from the guests. As you know, or should know, every major company uses data to determine what the customers, what the needs of the customers are, right? Airbnb is no different. So Airbnb uses your searches. They use what prior trips you took, especially if you're a returning customer. They're going to use your prior trips. They're going to see which properties you gave high ratings to, which properties you gave bad ratings to. They're also going to look at if you have wish lists and what type of properties you put on your wish list. This helps them determine which properties to push. Now, how I use this information to benefit me, I use this information so I can make my properties more attractable or more likely to be booked from a guest based on the trends of the traveler. In addition to that, I use this information to determine what type of properties I'm going to buy. So I'm going to give you an example of how valuable this information is. To this day, I still hear people say, more beds equals more money. That is not true, people. Data shows you that if you have a 5-bedroom house with 12 beds, it's not going to make you more money in today's traveler. Most travelers are not traveling in large groups. In addition to that, you also don't want to spend a lot of money on luxury Airbnbs. They're not occupied as high or not as sought after as smaller properties. You've been following my channel. I'm a big proponent on buying 3-bedroom, 2-baths, small ones, not large ones, 2 bedrooms, 2 baths, 2 bedrooms, 1 bath, studios and small apartments. The amount of travelers looking for that type of property is much greater, much broader than someone looking for a million plus property on the beach, right? Can you make money on that? Yes, you can. But if you're an investor, you really want a higher return on your money. You want a very high ROI. This data and these next few videos that I'm going to be providing, it's going to help you determine which properties are going to give you a high ROI, because these are the properties that Airbnb are pushing towards potential guests, because Airbnb is in business and they want to make money. And they realize that by receiving this data, by collecting this data, they can cater to the masses, not specifically cater to a small group of people. Again, to recap, Airbnb is gonna look at your search criteria, but more importantly, they're gonna look at what you did prior to. So your prior trips, the prior properties you booked and which ones you gave high marks to, so they can match you with that particular property. The other stuff they look at is pretty common sense, because you're actually gonna put it in there. They're gonna look at, did you put in a king bed as one of your criteria? Did you put in a pool as your criteria? Did you put in a coffee maker, for example? Those stuff are common sense, because that's in the search. But the stuff that's not so prevalent or not so evident is the one that I just talked about. They want to see what you did prior so they can match you with a similar property. Hope this information helps. If it did, please leave a comment, hit the like button, share, follow us on Instagram. Love you guys, and I'll see you in the next one.